Happiness, happiness, happiness. It's a word, if you were to ask me, could identify these two. Was it always like that? No. How does he know, you may ask? It doesn't matter right now. The only thing I could guarantee you is that their life wasn't happy at all, especially his. It was full of sorrow, loneliness, depression, and so many other negative things. But you know what? Let me show you, and you will see the life that he lived before. He grew up in a home with a father, mother, and siblings. They try to be happy. Emphasis on the word try. But it wasn't like that. I actually saw with my own eyes how their home was just getting destroyed little by little. Fights. Constant fights. Separation. So many things that happened. And look at him, so sad. At fault. Because yes, he thought that it was his fault that everything was happening. And I encouraged it too. I wanted him to feel that this whole hell that he was living, that was all his fault. Look at teenage Daniel trying to escape from the reality that he lived. Like so many other youth, that they think that by dating, by going out, hanging out with their friends, that that will suffice for them to escape from the reality that they live. But guess what? They're wrong. As he was just miserable. Look at him. Oh, failed attempts for sure. In this time, look at him, so exhausted, so tired, so lifeless. And that was actually my goal, if you ask. I did everything possible for him to suffer even in his own sleep. That is, probably not allowing him to sleep at all. Just making him think that everything that he lived was his fault. What's enough for me for him to suffer? For him not even to get rest when he shut his eyes. Look at him, thinking that he's going to be able to get out from the suffering that he's going through with alcohol and drugs. That's funny. But you know what? A lot of people actually think that way. And I actually like the fact that they do. Because they think that they're going to be able to run away from their problems consuming any sort of substance, when in reality, the fact, it won't. It'll make it worse. And trust me, I make sure of that. Dating, going out, clubbing, many things that people think that will help them kind of run away, or a door that they can knock and they will be able to go to another reality. It never did. It always led them to one, to the path of suffering. And I made sure that that happened consistently. He dated one, two, three. Everything was the same. It all ended to him feeling miserable, lonely, and in pain. One of my favorite moments, when I made him believe that death was the only solution to his problems. He felt like if he was drowning and that he was never going to make it out. It was so nice seeing him agonizing, trying to ask for help and no one being able to. It was great times seeing him in pain. With all the anger, I tell you that my downfall started here, when he came across that message that changed his life. that message that destroyed my plans, as it destroys the plans of those who have the same mission. But I was persistent. But I knew I was in danger, and I had to do something. But he had to obey him and decided to go to that place that I hate the most. That place that preaches truth, happiness, that leads them to the path that I do not want him to be in. And he walked there, and trust me, every step of the way, I made sure to bring doubt, to try to stop him, but I wasn't able to. There was something stronger than me. And he entered that place. And here we are. Now, he goes against me. He fights against my plan. He fights for those who are still under my wings. Those who I have under my domain. He has fought for so many and made them understand that happiness does exist. And that no one should suffer as long as they give an opportunity to the one that saved him, Jesus Christ. Now that you know the truth and the story, and yes, it's me, the one that robs, the one that destroys, and the one that kills, that was behind it. He was never at fault. But I made him believe that. But the moment that he surrendered to him, he became free. And with all the anger inside me, I tell you, happiness does exist. But as long as you're under my power, and I rule over you, you're never going to find that happiness. So it's your choice. Choose me. And trust me. Your life will be as I planned. But if you choose him, Jesus, your life will change. The decision is yours.